0007, turn right, heading 185, reduce speed 182 or not.
185 on heading 180 on speed go for 007.
Speed bit 124, reduce speed 160 or not to 40
of me. Reduce 160 to 4, speed 124.
Hello there guys, Matt here, hope you're all well, and welcome back to part 2 of my 2-part special Speedbird 15 from Heathrow to Singapore, then on to Sydney. Now, if you haven't watched part 1 and you're just joining in for part 2, then in the previous episode we flew the same aircraft on the real schedule of Speedbird 15, leaving Heathrow at 9:30 p.m. UK time, and then arriving into Singapore at what time was it? About 9:35 Zulu, something like that. Well, the time is now 10:20, or just past 10:20 Zulu, and we are going to be flying this next sector, which again is Speedbird 15 on VATSIM, down to Sydney. The real one departs at apparently 11:20, so we've got a good hour to set up. As I said, we're on VATSIM. Now, the problem is with VATSIM is that if someone else takes the call sign you want to use, then you have to use another one. And sadly, someone else is already flying Speedbird 15, so I had to use 15 Bravo. And the second bit of irony is Speedbird 15, the real one that is on VATSIM, is somewhere approaching the airfield right now. He's just being vectored around. I heard him on ATC about 5 minutes ago, so we should, well, we may not see him, but we'll definitely hear him. Not quite sure where his location is at the moment. Anyway, this is the leg that I'm most excited about. I actually cannot wait to get down to Sydney. It's, I don't know, there's just something about flying that far in two sectors that just excites me. Maybe I'm just a bit of a nerd like that, but oh well. So as far as everything goes, I've loaded all the payload and the fuel and stuff like that for people that are interested. 212.3 is the zero fuel weight, so a little bit under what we took out of Heathrow, but only 67 tons of fuel. This flight's about 6 hours, 55 minutes or thereabouts. So everything is good to go. We have ATC to speak to, so I'm going to keep the intro very brief, and I'm going to get on with actually getting out of here, because for some reason, when you have VATSIM ATC, it seems to take a lot longer to get out of somewhere than if you didn't have ATC. I guess that's just part and parcel of flying in VATSIM. I did see a Pakistan 777 just take off, but I wasn't recording at the time. Behind him was some sort of silk jet thing, 747 I think it was, or Silkway. Not quite sure. But it's pretty busy as far as arrivals go, not much on the ground. So I think the best idea is to just get underway and by the way, one problem, apparently Australia is in winter season at the moment, therefore when we get down to Sydney, it's about 5 a.m. their time. It may still be dark, it may just be becoming light. I'm really not quite sure. Dancing GSX trucks, very nice. So if that's the case, and I'm sorry, but it's just the way it goes, flying real time. So yeah, let's do this. Okay, so as before, overhead panel, we'll stick the ADIRUs on, or ADIRU, singular, and we can turn the emergency lights on. We're on ground power at the moment, but I will endeavour to fire up the APU, and we can turn on the seatbelt signs as the fueling's done. We'll turn the logo light on. It's approaching, I don't know if it's nighttime here or morning, I think it's nighttime, yeah, it's nighttime. So that can come on. I forgot to install the shift thing so it doesn't tilt off center of view. My bad. Fuel pumps can stay off for the moment. And the packs can stay where they are. Everything is set there. One thing I do actually need to do is reset the checklist. So we'll just go to the checklist page if it would come on. There we go. And then reset all. And we'll start with the before or the pre-flight checklist. I'll put that on the doors page for now, because we don't need to do that just yet. If I could find the door page, that is. I don't have much muscle memory when it comes to the lower ECAM or ECAS, whatever they're called, display buttons. I don't know why, even though I press them like a million times. Anyway, FMC, we have a company route today. So position init. and we are Singapore, so Whiskey, Sierra, Sierra, Sierra. Gate is Charlie 22, same as we landed. And we can take the GPS position like so. We can request the route here, which is Sin Sid. Request that. And that will load in like last time. Catering vehicles are in position, which means we can open the catering doors while that's doing that. So FS Actions doors, and then we can open entry 2 and entry 5 for them to do that. Just as we do that, the company route has loaded like so. So we can load that in, and then we can enter the blanks, or fill in the blanks, should I say. Now, I did say ATC is online, and that is still the case. As far as ATC, we have Singapore ground, Singapore ATIS, and Singapore, I guess, approach. I don't know what it's called. So we'll just go with that in a minute, and we'll see where we are heading, off what runway. Speedbird 15 Bravo, sadly, because as I said, the other one is inbound to land. And runway at the moment, I need to check. I think it's 20 center, but they have an ATIS online, which is on 128.6. So we'll tune that now and we'll see what it says.
Bus reports is in use. Semi next parallel runway operating. Initial climb 3,000 feet. Landing runway 20 center and 20 right. Departing runway 20 center. Simultaneous approach is in
okay,
use.
So it's departing runway 20 center.
Assigned altitudes. Acknowledge receipt of information Sierra and advise aircraft type.
Sierra 1008.
Shanky Airport information.
Okay, so 20 center, information Sierra, QNH 1008, and delivery is online, and its frequency is 121. Decimal 650, so we'll tune him and request clearance.
390 and say again, score code for decimal 582.
582 score code is 1160.
I'll confirm 1600 for decimal 582.
Delivery, good evening. Speedbird 15 Bravo, 777-300 on stand, Charlie 22. We have information Sierra with 1008. Request clearance to Sydney.
Echo calling, please take call sign.
Speedbird 15 Bravo.
Speedbird 15 Bravo, stand by your number one. Speedbird 15 Bravo, I have your clearance info, advisory, ready to copy.
We're ready to copy, Speedbird 15 Bravo.
Speedbird 15 Bravo, you're clear to Sydney Airport as far by the Vampire 1 Bravo departure, server transition. Initial climb 3000, expect flight level 350, squawk 236.
Can you say the transponder code once more? You broke up, Speedbird 15 Bravo.
Speedbird 15 Bravo, squawk 2367.
Okay, cleared to cleared to Sydney, Vempa 1 Bravo departure with the Serga transition. Climb initially 3,000 feet and squawk 2367, Speedbird 15 Bravo. 6-7, set. Hopefully that's alright. So we can get rid of all that now, 2367, it's a 1 Bravo departure. And then we can go back and program that into the FMC You didn't give me a readback correct, but I just assume that it's from...
315 Bravo, readback is correct. Contact Singapore ground, 124.3, good night.
124.3, speedbird 15 Bravo, thanks, good night. Okay, so he sent me straight to ground, 124.3. 124.3, and switch to there. While we set up the FMC. Okay, so depart arrived, depart 20 center, and the Vempo 1 Bravo is there. Serga transition, we can activate that. Init ref, we can perf init request it. We're going up to flight level 350, he said we can expect that, which is good. There's the request sent. I'm going to get GSX to do stuff. Actually, no, I'm not, because it's still not ready. Okay, we can accept that, apart from we need to change the level. I don't know why it's sending us a 330 initially, but that's fine. Thrust limit, takeoff 60, flap 5, CG is whatever it gives us, 28%. There we go, 74, and the takeoff weight is 278.1. So that's in there. And we can have a look at the wind, actually. We'll fill out all this weather page for a change. So the meta here is 200. There's no slope. The outside air temperature is 29. And thrust reduction climb to 1500 feet.
And you're doing 266 again, please?
And 3000 feet acceleration altitude.
You're doing 266
your last
there. I'm moving, but if I'm not moving again, I'll.
So we'll just confirm all those. 173 is what we need to set in the MCP. 173. We'll sync the heading up with that. Okay. So, now that's in.
I'm
going to do everything on the other side. Move that to takeoff page. So, we are looking route data, and then we are looking. Serga, we are looking for 330, 350, 370, 390. We are going to be 350 at Serga, and minus 56, in it goes. Execute wind data request, let that pick itself up. Wait for the request to come through, there it is. Load those and execute those. Right, let's have a look at step climbs even. So 3.5 to 3.7 at Boydie, and then that's it. Where's Boydie? Have I gone past it? Why can't I find Boydie? It's after ARG. ARG direct Boydie direct TNK. Weird. We'll do it 370 at TNK. I don't know why that's not there. Oh no, it is there. Okay, I'm stupid. The step climbs at TNK. Forget I said that. Okay, so transition altitude is on my charts, which I should have had out ready for this, but I didn't. I just saw something, actually. You see this TCAS here? I don't know if we're going to be able to see him, but it's the Speedbird 15 that I was talking about. I don't know which runway he's landing on. Although, I think that's in there, actually. Yes, there he is. That's Speedbird 15. In from Heathrow. There you go. You can watch him land while I'm getting my charts ready. But yeah, that's the call sign I wanted, but now he took it. Which is fine. I hope he greases it. And I hope he doesn't want my stand. because otherwise there'll be a bit of a wait. Nice. That's so cool. Anyway, back on with programming. So, yeah, the transition altitude is 11,000 feet, which I'm going to do on the other side. So, 11,000 feet is in there. We can put the descent winds in, just so it gives it a better idea of what's going on. Auto brake can go to RTO. I am not interested in anything else at the moment. Sydney with 18.2. Yeah, plenty of fuel. Life is good. Okay, that can stay on the next page. We're all done with that, I think. Flight director on the left, flight director on the right. We can just sort out all the ND stuff here, so...
Singapore ground, Speedbird 15, would you vacate the runway on Whiskey 6?
Oh, there you go. You just heard him. Speedbird 15. We'll take data and terrain on this side.
Speedbird 15, good evening. Singapore ground, taxi to Kilo Charge via Whiskey 5. Good day.
Now, for this side, we want data, and we'll take weather radar eventually. Not quite yet.
Speedbird 15, taxi to Kilo Charge via Whiskey 5. Come on, standby. Good day.
Okay, catering's done.
We
can close the. The cargo stuff and the catering doors. Pushback and. Actually, we'll let GSX sort out the pushback. Everything else is done. We'll put the fuel pumps on now. I will squawk Charlie, which we're already doing, it's fine. And we'll do the checklist.
With 302 Singapore ground, good evening. Approaching start approved,
the doors
not cost effective.
Oxygen we can, well, we don't bother with. Flight insurance is set, parking brake is also set, the pre-flight checklist is complete. So that's before start checklist next, but not quite ready for that because we've still got some doors open. And we've got a boarding request it or whatever it's done. People were saying in the last video that I deboard it before I board it, and I didn't realize I was doing that, which is kind of bad of me. But oh well. Oh, there's the other one. Is he waiting for my gate? If he actually waits for my gate, then fair play to him. But I don't think he will. I swear I just saw an aircraft tail over there. I think I did. Is that? Yeah, it is. It's going at like Mach 2 though. What is that? Is that China? China? Oh no, it's Malaysian, of course. Why didn't I know that? Okay, I'm just chilling out there. Put your flaps up, dude. Oh, there's another one landing. We're getting treated today by all the traffic. Can't see him just yet, though. He's a little bit far out. Boarding is almost done, apparently. We need to close entry 5 left, which is that one. There you go. We can arm all of these doors now. And arm. Does it want me to close anything else? Nope. We'll close the front doors as well. Close, close. And we can arm them too. Arm and arm. Good, APU is running, so that's all good. We can go to the checklist now. So flight deck door is not simulated, so MCP set. Takeoff speeds are set, senior pre-flight is complete, trim is done, taxi takeoff briefing is done, and of course the last thing to come on is the beacon light. So that's that done. We go to the engine page and we can disconnect all of the external stuff. So we'll get rid of that. And we'll also get rid of anything that is connected to the aircraft, like so. And we are ready for pushback and start, I would believe. So let's call him for that. Ground Speedbird 15, Bravo, requests push and start off Charlie 22.
15 Bravo, good evening. Singapore Ground, push inside approved, face north, call for taxi.
Push inside approved, face north, we'll call for taxi, speed 15 Bravo. There's something landing there, I don't know what it is. It is a Emirates 777. And the parking brake is released.
And a speed 5 Bravo, swim with standby.
Squawk standby, okay. Speed 15 Bravo. Interesting. Pressurize, etc. There's the other guy pulling into the gate, just off our right hand side. That Charlie 20 sign obviously doesn't like life. Quite sure what's going on there. Has that guy landed yet? Yeah, I missed it. Whoops. But he just comes flying past the. Yep, there he is. Reverses out, everything else out. So cool. Okay, I'll carry on pressurizing. Like so. And on the pushback, we can fire up the right engine straight away. That looks so cool. Where's he gone, the Emirates? There he is. GSX didn't ask me which direction to face, so I'm not quite sure where it's going to take me.
Ground Singapore. Ground to the
MH404, good evening, Singapore Ground. Squawk mode, stand by taxi to gate of choice via Whiskey Papa, good day.
Good day, MH404.
You know what? I'm going to tell GSX to just stop here. Because, yeah, it's just going to keep pushing me back into the middle of nowhere, so. Engine 1.
Singapore Ground, Bullet 302, taxi to holding point Echo 1, runway 20, enter via taxiways Charlie 6, Charlie 1, Echo Papa, QNH 1008.
Roger, taxi, Echo 7, runway 20, enter Echo 1 by Charlie 6.
Jim 1's just coming online. Emirates. Where's that Emirates gone? Oh, there he is, he's taxiing.
Emirates 404, almost standby, please.
Almost standby.
Okay, I'm going to the flight control page, which is here. So flat 5, 1 and 5, full left, full right, all the way up, all the way down, full rudder left, and full rudder right. The trim is needs to be 5.5, so there's 7, 5, 2, 5 and 5, 5. That is all set. We can go back to the checklist. Anti-ice is not required. Recall checked. Just TCAS, but that's no problem. Flight controls checked and ground equipment is clear. That's the before takeoff checklist also done, but we'll come back to that in just a second. So, turn offs, taxi lights, and we can ditch the APU. Let's call for taxi. Ground speed 15 Bravo, request taxi.
Speed 15 Bravo, taxi holding point Echo North, runway 20, center via taxiway, uniform 1, Whiskey Alpha North Cross 3, Greenwich 1008.
Let's have a look where he sent us. Crossing somewhere. North Cross 3, okay. Taxi to Echo North, runway 20 center via Uniform 1, and then Whiskey Alpha North, and cross November Charlie 3, speed 15 Bravo.
November Charlie 3,
So, it's a bit of a weird taxiway system at Singapore, but essentially this taxiway here is uniform, so we'll swing it around to the left, and then you kind of go that way, and then you go right onto a taxiway called November. Well, it says NNC3 on the chart, but I guess that's North Charlie 3, hence the clearance. That's the that call sign is the call sign that we use for World Flight on the 777. It's pretty cool. Okay, there we go. So this is Uniform. Uniform's going to go on to Whiskey Alpha. And then we're going to go on the north side, I would imagine. Yeah, to Whiskey Echo North, even. Echo North. That's where we've been cleared to. It's getting dark. Sad times. Actually, you know what I should do? I should have looked to see where that Emirates was. So I just taxied without looking to the left. Oh, there's a Qantas 737 at Singapore. Am I going crazy? Yeah, so this is November or North Charlie 3. So I guess it's this right-hand turn here. I think it's this one here. North Charlie 3 would make sense. And then it's this all the way to Echo North for runway 20 center. And is Tower still online? Maybe, maybe not. Who knows? Tower is still online, and this frequency is 1186. So we'll pre-tune that while we're taxiing. 1186, like so. And then the departure frequency is 120.3. And then we have control from Jakarta Center, which is nice. . 11:20, look at the time. Scheduled departure time is right now. What I did forget to do was turn on the clock over there so we could get a proper block time, but never mind, I'll do that now. Nothing in the way. There's something a bit laggy when I look over there, like I'm going down to like zero frames. Over here is fine though, no problem. Something over there. Sadly, we're taking off in that direction, so there we go. Oh, what's this? There's a 777 here. Who is that? Oh, there's no livery on it. It's just Boeing house calls. Interesting. Right, now it's time to squawk mode, Charlie, because we are ready. So we'll do that. There's an aircraft actually landing on 20 right. I can't see him though. You can see him on TCAT, so move that in. Weather radar can come on now. Here we are, at Echo North, runway 20 center.
Scooter 302, contact Singapore Tower, 118.6 to base. Roger, going to Tower 11, need this move. Good afternoon, good afternoon, thank you, bye-bye.
Viva 15, Bravo, contact Singapore Tower, 11.6, number 2.
Over to 118.6, 4 speedbird 15 Bravo. Thanks, bye bye.
Good day.
There's no stop bar sometimes. Hold the brakes.
Look at this, good evening, and this will be runway 2 0 right.
Singapore Tower, good evening. Speedbird 15 Bravo holding Echo North 20 Center.
Roger.
So we're number 2 behind this guy.
KLM 427. Okay, contact ground on 124.3. Confirm.
Contact ground
124.3. Okay, contact ground 124.3. Thank you.
Bye bye. Speedbird taking his time. Come on, man. We've got planes to fly. Oh, I thought that guy was Speedbird. It's not Speedbird, it's Scoot. Scoot 302. Approach frequency is 120.3, so let's pre-tune that. There we go. Still waiting for some sort of clearance to line up and depart, but oh well, we're good for now. Cliff takeoff on 20 center, speedbird 15 Bravo. Good stuff. Lights. And the clock.
Approaching 20 center.
The rolling takeoff. Everything is ready and good to go.
On runway.
Weather's
two,
on, terrain's
zero,
on.
Center.
Keep it rolling. Power's coming in. Stable. Toga. Eighty knots and power set. Moss Freight, Europe. Thrust reduction very, very soon. You'll hear the climb power kick in. 120.3, speedway 15 Bravo. Thanks, good day. Okay, that's climb power, 1203. Approach, good evening, Speedbird 15 Bravo, passing 2500 on the Venpo 1 Bravo departure. To level, and just for now, you can take the autopilot. Approach is like GG'd out, so, I mean. There's that. AFM, we are 3,000 feet, Vempa 1 Bravo departure.
Bravo, good evening. Radar identified climb in same flight level 240, track direct does known. Altitude restrictions and key restrictions is removed.
Okay, free speed, direct to Dosno and climb flight level 240, Speedbird 15 Bravo. Perfect. So, 240, we're direct to Dosno, like so, LNAV, VNAV. And that's going to try and speed us up now. We're going to go VNAV, and we're going to delete that 250 below 10, so it'll go to Econ speed. Flap coming to 1. Sync that heading up. And flaps up. And then we should just accelerate very nicely. See what's going on down there. Not much really. We're cleared to a flight level, so I'll set standard pressure. Yeah, if you ever get a no speed restriction or a zero like free speed restriction, utilize it because especially on longer flights, getting fast quickly is a good plan. So you know we're way above 250 below 10, but that's because he wavered that speed restriction for us, which is really nice of him. We're accelerating to 320 knots. Still doing 1500 feet a minute, that's not too bad. Good old G90s. Some random airport down. Oh, there's a bit of a thunderstorm over there. I guess that's what that red bit is on the weather radar there. So, let's have a look on the. Put that on VNAV for now. And we'll have a look. So we're landing at 1808 Zulu, 17 and a half tons of fuel. I still think we're probably going to land when it's dark. I'm hoping it may just be coming sunrise. We'll see. We'll see what I can do. We'll see what I can pull out the bag. But I'm going to flick the landing lights off now because there's nothing in the way. We don't need them. And also the logo light. Whoops. Logo light can come off. And it looks like a relatively smooth day. Apart from that bit of storm over there, but we're not going anywhere near that, so it's not really that much of an issue. So all the way to flight level 240 we go. Everything is cleaned up. We can do the after takeoff checklist, which is landing gears up and the flaps are up. And of course, the next thing for now is the descent, but we are nowhere near that. So, cue the awesome views. And cue the crazy weather that's just appeared in front of us. And let's see if we can make it to Singapore in time for daylight. Fingers crossed. Welcome back. Because I am a genius, I did a bit of slowing down, shall we say, in the cruise. And I've managed to make it so that we are landing just as the sun is rising, because I figured that if I went... The problem is that all the way here, we had 135 knot tailwind, so I was flying almost at stall speed to make this happen. But it's done, and I figured that if we landed it in the night, then it would really be very pointless. So landing in the morning would be preferable. So we've kind of done that-ish. We're just inbound to the Sierra Charlie Oscar. NDB, I think it is. Is it NDB? I would hope so. Let's have a look what's after that. After that's a place called Corky, then Sadlo, and then into Sydney. Need to program some arrival stuff, hence why I've jumped in a little bit earlier than usual. So we are arriving on, I've no idea. The wind is 330 degrees at 5 knots. I guess I could, actually no, I can't check flight radar. I'm just going to go with, let's see, 3-4 left, I guess. Yeah, 3-4 left. We'll do 3-4 left. ILS approach, 3-4 left. I'm not sure if we can use any of the stars, because my last point on the flight plan is coming from a place called TSAT, and there is nothing from TSAT, so maybe it's just a case of routing direct to maybe this place. Sausage? What? Is there really a fix called sausage? Is that happening? Let's have a look at the charts and see what's what. So, yeah, there's only a few stars, none of which are coming from my direction, it would seem, unless I've completely misread all of these approach plates. TSAT is right over the airfield, so yeah, it's definitely not any of the stars. So it's just going to route to TSAT. I guess we'd probably just get vectored around and for 3-4 left. So the ILS chart for 3-4 left says that we have a decision altitude of 220 feet. We can put that in just a second. But first of all, I want to reload the new winds in and put all the details in. I'm trying to find, oh, there we go. The transition altitude, or level even, is 110. So we can put that in there, like that. And then we can load the winds in, like so. Landing weight for us is, let's see, 224.6. So we'll stick that in, and we'll be using flap 30. That's all good. So as I said, the decision altitude is 220 feet. We can put that into barrow, so we'll go down the scale. So 370, 360, 350, 40, 30, and 220 is set. Gorgeous sunrise, though. Where is the sun? Is it behind there? Yeah, it is. You can just see it there. There's a moon going away. Moon, sun, etc. You get the point. We'll be using auto brake numero 2, and looking at the charts for the aerodrome, landing on runway 3-4 left, we are going to vacate on maybe Alpha 2. There's a rapid exit on Alpha 2, then we can cross runway 2507 and then from Golf into the gates. The international terminal is on the western side of Sydney, so that's what we'll be aiming for. You know what I'll do, though? I'll put some range rings in so I get an idea of where I am. I don't want it to be another Sydney where I end up having to go around due to not being prepped in time. I did have range rings on the Sydney leg. Sorry, the Singapore leg even. Wait, did I say Singapore? I meant Sydney. No, I don't even know anymore. You know what I mean? The last video, when we went around, I didn't want to do that. And the reason why that happened is because I didn't prep myself quick enough. Although I thought that I had done. So, there's that. Right, okay, that's done. Everything's in. It's actually quite nice on the ground at Sydney. It's 330 degrees, 5 knots, Cav OK, 12 degrees, so it's a little cold. 1028 is the barometric pressure. So we can set that now. Let's do that. 1028 set, and there's no sig, as in no significant change. So yeah, everything is going well. I look forward to the arrival in Sydney, and more importantly, the scenery. 6 hours and 32 minutes on the clock, and we have an allotted time of 6 hours 55, so yeah, I'll talk to you more when we're in the descent, now we have everything planned. Thank you. Okay, so the excitement begins. We're just passing 175 for 4,000, and essentially we need to position ourselves over here somewhere. Let me kind of just zoom into the ND so you can see. I've got plan mode, and then I'll zoom in. So what we're up here somewhere. We're coming down this way. I put us on a heading of 150. There's no ATC on, so we're not going to get vectored by them, so you kind of have to do it yourself. So 150 will bring us out this way, and then we're going to follow round to the right and establish on runway 34 left. Everything else is set up, which is good, so we're all ready to go. Hopefully going this way is better than going that way, or the west, out to the west. I have a feeling the residents of Sydney would much prefer a couple of G90s powering up over the water than they would over the town. Or over the city, should I say. So that's why I'm going that way, out of the way. There isn't anything in the way as far as obstacles. So have an MSA, so a sector safe altitude, on the western side, which we're going nowhere near, of 2,100 feet. There's nothing on the eastern side, so again, that's probably the better decision. We are, let's see, probably about 35 miles to go until touchdown. The progress page will say 60, there you go, but that's not taking into consideration everything else. So if we say, we'll do about maybe 40 miles to go, but it's looking good. The weather is really nice. I don't know where the scenery starts. I know that they have modeled some of the surrounding area, but I'm not sure where exactly it starts. I've not seen anything of it just yet. I'm hoping the frames are okay. I tested it in the Cessna 172, the A2A172, and it seemed great. Probably not the best idea, considering I'm flying in the 777. But regardless, I think we should be just fine. So we're approaching the 15-mile range ring, and then once we're there, we're just going to square it to the right, so heading 160. Fly on the right-hand downwind, slow it down, get some flaps out, and then we'll fly a right base at about 10 miles, and then we'll establish between sort of 8 and 10 miles, depending on how sharp the turn is. Okay, have I rambled on enough about what my plans are? Are you excited? I don't know why I'm so excited about the scenery. I don't get excited about scenery at all. I think it's just because I've been waiting for so long to be able to fly down to Sydney with good scenery, and it's just never happened. So there you go. All I can say is world flight this year will be exceptionally fun, especially the start and the end legs. But yeah, so we're just crossing the 15-mile ring now, and so we're going to square off the heading to 160. There we go, and we'll turn to the right. You can see the scenery loading in just underneath us there. Some black texturing. It's not really too bad though, I'm sure that'll go away. There's some sort of, I don't know if this is part of the scenery, this, all of these buildings, or if that's just already in sort of Orbex, whatever it is, Service Pack 4 Australia. But yeah, whatever. That's cool. Landing lights can go on, turn offs can go on, and we can do some checklists. So the descent checklist, we should have done this a while ago, but recall was already checked, notes, whatever. Water break set, landing data is set, and the approach briefing is completed. And then, of course, the approach checklist. The altimeter's now 1028, and that is set. If it will let me click it. There we go. Normal. Okay, so now it's just a landing checklist. We can get rid of that for now. We have, let's see, so 10 to there, 10, 10, 15, 20-odd miles, 23, 24 miles to go. So I'm going to go into flight level change, and I'm going to start to slow it down, because it's fine to go as far as we need to go out this way. There's no restrictions on that side of Sydney, on the south side, which is good. And if we look out to the right, you will see, where is it? There it is. There's Sydney. How nice. Looking very suave indeed. Okay, so we're just descending through 7,000 now, and flap 1, speed 200 knots, 4,000 feet. The descent arc, or whatever it's called, is telling us we'll be level very soon. So what I'm going to do is swing it to the right, about heading 200-ish. That sunset, though, or sunrise even, wrong time of day, is absolutely amazing. Really, really nice. Turning right now. Still going more right. We'll be able to see Sydney now if we look back on ourselves. Where is it? It's over there somewhere. There you go. It's there. Beautiful. We'll continue that right even further. Range is 10 miles now. Go 250 on the heading-ish. We're 11 miles to go. We're 11 miles from the ILS even. We'll reduce that range in so we can see what we're doing. Looking good so far. We'll profile it down to 3,000 feet. And we'll also bring out flap 5. You can see there's the glide slope diamond. Bring out more speed brake, get it all the way out, get some hefty descent going on. Perfect. Descending at 1500 feet a minute. And now we can turn right to intercept. So we'll do 315, give it a nice gentle cut. We might end up going through, actually, so in that case we can just continue the right turn to, let's see, 360 will be okay. There's the glide coming online now. We'll just shoot through that, but we'll hit the localizer mode anyway. And we'll go through 3,000 feet, we'll descend to 2,000. We'll keep that flight level change in, and then we'll use that altitude to our advantage. We'll just keep going down. Should be good. We'll drop the gear out, give it a bit more drag. Visibility's a bit rubbish, sadly. We want to go through the glide just so we've got some time to level and then do everything else. There we go, perfect. Bring the speed all the way down now. We'll go flat 15 and on the approach mode. And then we'll check 142. We'll do 147. We can arm the speed brake now. Were you done with it? Lights are all on, already done that bit. Everything is good, slowing down nicely. Can't see the scenery yet because the visibility is terrible, but it's okay. And we can do the landing checklist, which is, apart from the flaps, pretty much there. Perfect, landing checklist complete. Clear to land, no ATC at the moment. I'm going to get rid of the autopilot. We'll keep the auto throttle in, as per. And I can see the runway now, 12 o'clock of us, looking good. Beautiful. Regardless of that morning mist, the weather is absolutely sublime for flying.
1,000.
Perfect. A little bit high, but we'll correct that.
Approaching 3, 4, left.
Good old RAAS stating the obvious. Stable. Welcome to Sydney. Ease the nose down, very nice. All the brakes doing their thing, reversers doing their thing also. Decelerating through 60 with the auto brake there. Bring the reversers in, we'll take the next on the left. Alpha 2, just like I predicted. And that was awesome. God damn it, Fly Tampa. So cool. Look at the what is that? Look at the water on the ground. Bring the flaps in, speed brake in, get rid of the flight directors, and we'll turn the lights off, keep the turn offs and the taxi on, get rid of the strobes, we'll fire up the APU, and we'll continue the taxi right here on Alpha, cross the runway, and then turn left on Golf, and then we'll find somewhere to park.
0-7.
So cool. So, so cool. They have, I wonder if I can get an external view. There we go. They have a shark, which maybe I'll do like an in-depth video of Sydney at one point in my life, but not right now. But they had a shark that just sort of swims around the bay over there to the left somewhere, and it's pretty cool. So if you go get yourself like a Cessna or something and just go have an explorer of the area. They've got some McDonald's restaurants, if that's your thing, in before people say it's my thing. RIP. But yeah, it's really nice scenery. Faith for me was restored with Fly Tampa when they did Copenhagen. And and everything since then is just beautiful, so. It's all good, it's all good. But you can just see, like, look at this, just really random bits of decals and stuff on the scenery that just make it completely awesome. But I'm going to go into one of these gates on the right because they seem pretty hefty for a 777, which is good. And 7 hours and 4 minutes on the clock, 7 hours and 12 minutes on that side. Not bad at all. Can you believe 2 days ago we left London and now we're in Australia? Crazy stuff. Which gate? Eeny, meeny, miny, mo. This one will do. Turn the turn-offs and the taxi lights off. And we'll pull into this stand here. Round we go. The view is like so askew, it's so difficult to park. That'll do. Parking brake on. And everything else is on, so we can just shut the engines down. There we go, done. So, there we go. The end of our epic trip down to Sydney. I thoroughly enjoyed that, although my parking is absolutely atrocious. Look at that. It's nowhere near the line. It's because the you know the problem with EasyDock where the world camera like moves so you don't have the center line of the nose. It's all very sort of skew and things like that. It's not very fun. But yeah, this scenery is absolutely outstanding and I'm so glad I did it. So I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you enjoyed both parts. And yeah, Fly Tampa, seriously, I don't know if any of them watch my videos, but I'm sure it'll get back to them somehow. Excellent job. Thank you very much for making such an awesome bit of scenery. It's much appreciated by, I would imagine, everybody. I may do some sort of video from here again using a different aircraft going somewhere, maybe LAX or somewhere like that. I don't know, we'll see. But for now, I bid you farewell. And again, if you have any suggestions of what you would like to see, as I say in all of my videos, don't forget to just comment and whichever gets the most upvotes, if you will, in before I get accused of being a Reddit whore. Then I will, I'll have a look and we'll see what we can do. But yeah, from myself and Golf Sierra Tango Bravo Hotel, it's been a good couple of days. Thanks for watching, and until the next video, take care and goodbye.